गुड मॉर्निंग सर. गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
प्लीज सर.
थैंक यू सर.
और वैशाली.
आई एम गुड सर. थैंक यू.
गुड. वी हैव सीन योर डैब.
यस सर.
अदर देन डैब डू यू हैव एनीथिंग टू से अबाउट योरसेल्फ? नथिंग अबाउट दैट. एनीथिंग एल्स?
सर आई हैव नॉट मेंशनड अबाउट माय करंट एम्प्लॉयमेंट स्टेटस. आई हैव क्लियर्ड इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन इन द ईयर 2019. On the basis of which I have been allotted border road engineering services.
And border sir, roads?
Yes, sir. Okay. And sir, I'll be joining in first week of September.
Anything else about your siblings? Or?
Sir, I have two siblings. The eldest one is my brother. He is working in the private sector. And my elder sister, she is into the services.
Which service?
Sir, Indian Audit and Account Services.
And you have been Delhi throughout?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just tell me, you have been a best women student. What were the criteria for selection of the best student?
So the criteria was largely academic, and the CGPA, I got the CGPA of 10. That is why I was eligible for this particular.
It's only academic, no extracurricular activities for this.
So the criteria was academic for this particular award.
This paper quilling.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, for which strata of the public you cater to? For children or for elders?
Sir, I generally make greeting cards, personalized greeting cards for my friends, family, using paper quilling. And sir, recently I have also tried paper quilling for making earrings and other 3D objects as well.
And, you are displaying also somewhere or only just
for your sir, as a part of hobby only, sir.
You are reading newspaper. Which paper generally you read?
Yes, sir. I read Indian Express and the Times of India.
And Times of India.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, Mysore case, you know.
Hmm? Yes,
sir. Mysore, what happened in Chamundi Hills.
Yes, sir.
Hmm? You are DGP of the state.
Yes, sir.
We know that is this our responsibility, state's responsibility to protect everybody.
Yes, sir.
But state cannot go to each and every place and ensure that safety of citizens is there. Home Minister gave some statement.
Yes, sir.
He is in trouble.
Yes, sir.
In a way, he gave two remarks. One is about himself and one about that people should not be going. One way it is correct that state cannot go everywhere.
Yes, sir.
And you are in a fixed, complex situation. How are you going to live? Knowing very well that people themselves also must realize, because they must see their safety also, but state also is responsible.
Yes, sir. Sir, in the issue of women's safety or the citizen safety by large, sir, firstly the responsibility is largely of the state. And even about the awareness aspect among the citizens, about which routes to take or which are the areas where one should not go after evening or in late night. So the awareness campaign has also to be conducted by the state. And sir, secondly, we can also train our women in self-defense. That can be made a part of curriculum in schools so that they are better able to cope up with that kind of situation. And sir, thirdly, we need to sensitize our forces as well. While conducting investigation in such cases, there has to be sensitization.
But see, in those situations, the self-defense will not help.
Yes, sir.
And there are some scrupulous elements in the society. Whatever state does, they
yes,
will
sir.
Be all just telling against.
Yes, sir. Sir, we can also work on the front of improving the conviction rate in such cases so that itself acts as a deterrent in such cases, because conviction rate is very low as far as the POCSO or the rape cases are there.
So actually in these situations, awareness is the most important.
Yes,
people
sir.
Must realize that whatever the state does, that if you are going to some places where police or the machinery cannot be there, so they have to take care of themselves.
Yes, sir.
Our presidency is ending on 31st, UN.
Yes, sir.
So what the change, some change has been there in our statement. What is India's, that is statement from the UN side, but what India is thinking about?
Sir, Sir, our prime focus in the UNC was maritime security and terrorism, and we have been successfully able to take up those issues on the global platform. So that can be counted as the achievement, and the fact that this was the first time that India hold the presidency itself speaks volumes about our soft diplomacy.
But that removing that Taliban name,
yes,
what does it indicate?
Sorry, sir, I'm not able to think on those lines.
So, has there been increase in crime in the last 10, 15, 20 years? And if so, in what sectors the crime rate has increased?
Sir, as per the NCRB data, the crime rate has increased. And the crime rate has largely increased against the vulnerable sections of our society. First being women. The atrocities against SCSTs has also increased by around 6%. And sir, a new era of domain of crimes has also emerged, like the digital crimes, pornography,
cyber
crimes. Thank you, sir. So these all are also there.
The conviction rate is low.
Yes, sir.
In box offices.
Yes, sir.
What are the reasons you think for the very low rate of conviction?
Sir, there are many reasons. The first one being that in more than 90% of the cases, the assaulter is a known one. The family is a bit reluctant in reporting the cases. Sir, second one would be that there has been recent amendments in the Act.
No, when you say conviction rate,
yes, sir.
The cases have been booked, that means
yes,
reported.
Sir. Yes, sir.
And it has brought to the trial before court, and then only
yes,
the conviction is decided. Okay, so you are saying I am not asking about unreported cases.
Yes, sir.
What is the conviction rate? Why it is low in the registered cases?
Sir, proper investigation methods like forensic arm of the investigation forces needs to be strengthened. Because in the absence of evidences,
I'm not asking what are the remedies, what are the reasons?
Yes, sir. Sir, first one would be the child is very vulnerable after the assault, and in most of the cases they are not able to give the statements properly in the courts. And sir, secondly, the forces, the investigation and the charge sheet itself sometimes is very weak for convicting the offenders. So these are the two reasons primarily that I can think of.
Charge sheet is weak and the statement of the victim is not recorded properly.
Yes, sir.
These are all the two reasons. Okay. When charge sheet is weak, now tell me how to strengthen it.
Sir, firstly, we need to have the scientific and dedicated investigating team for these cases. Sensitization of the forces in such cases can be proved beneficial, because dealing with a victim, especially a child, that requires certain kind of expertise. And sir, thirdly, we can also have online or video conferencing. So, for the court, so that the child is in a better environment to identify the assaulter and give his or her statement.
Okay. Now tell me, you know what are the things happening in Afghan?
Yes, sir.
Last 3 or 4 days, what are the developments? Can you report? Make a report.
Sir, could you please give me a moment? Thank you. Sir, after the Taliban takeover of Kabul, there was a state of chaos among the Afghan people, and they were trying to flee from the country. That created a ruckus on the airport, and sir, there was a bomb blast also. There were 2 bomb blasts also on the airport, killing hundreds of Afghan people as well as the US troops. And sir, our country has been evacuating the diplomats and the citizens and the minorities from the Afghanistan, and the situation is largely volatile. with ISI and Taliban seemingly taking the center stage in the government.
What was the response or reaction of Taliban's for this bomb blast?
Sir, so there was a the IAS has claimed that it had planted the bomb in the airport. The Taliban is largely focusing on the 31st August, that is the last evacuation date, and it has said that it will not allow people after 31st of August to access the airport or flee the country.
IAS is responsible means they are not listening to Taliban.
Yes, sir.
Hmm?
Sir, IAS have said that the Taliban are the pseudo arms of the American forces, and IAS being more radical than Taliban, then that is why they are disapproving the capture of Kabul.
Okay. There was a news item about Islamic State of Khorasan province.
Sorry, sir?
Islamic State of Khorasan province.
Yes, sir.
Why it was in the news?
Sir, it is the wing of IAS in Afghanistan, in the Khorasan province of Afghanistan, and it is that wing which has taken the responsibility of the bombs, bomb blasts on the airport. Sir.
Apart from taking responsibility for this bombing, what else came in the press?
Sir, I am not able to think of.
It is reported that they are recruiting Indian citizens also in that place.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, tell me, what is the latest about Gaganyaan?
Sir, I am not aware about this latest developments on Gaganyaan. It is a human space mission.
What is the reflective dairy rating? Dairy rating itself is a sort of... Why you add an adjective for this?
Sir, diary writing could also be the mere reporting of the day-to-day activities of one's life. Sir, in reflective diary writing, I note down the decisions, the circumstances in which I take that decisions, and after a week or so, I reflect upon those decisions and then I make a judgment whether the decision was rational or emotive.
So okay, if it doesn't compromise on your privacy,
yes, sir.
Can you share such reflections?
Sir, in one of the reflections was a bit philosophical about life. Like how we think that the situations are not.
What was the decision you made and how did you reflect on it?
Sir, it was the death of my pet that had shattered me, and after that I wrote that diary, and then after reflecting upon it I realized that we should cherish people and the living beings who are around us for their presence and for the memories that they have given us, instead of mourning of their loss.
Okay. What was the reflection after that?
Sir, this was the reflection. I had noted down my emotions at that point of time, sir.
Okay. So, can you tell us how many gates are there in Delhi?
There were 14 gates, but at present, there are 7
gates which are there in Delhi, like Lahori Gate, Ajmeri Gate, Mori Gate, Kashmiri Gate.
Why is Kashmiri Gate called Kashmiri Gate?
Ma'am, these gates are named based upon the direction in which they point. Like the Lahori Gate points towards the Lahore, the Kashmiri Gate points towards the Kashmir. So these were the entry points for the ancient city of Delhi.
Shastri Nagar. Where is Shastri Nagar? Where exactly is this located in northwest Delhi? Is it like East Delhi towards East Delhi or?
Ma'am, it's around the center of Delhi. So it's on the easternmost part of the northwest district of Delhi.
So you know, there used to be, people used to say it is Jamna Par. So what do you mean by that?
It's towards the east of Jamna.
So, okay.
And ma'am, it's largely the center, geographical center of the Union Territory of Delhi.
But why was Jamna Par called, that area used to be called as Jamna Par?
Ma'am, because it could be related to the fact that people were earlier hesitant to cross the rivers, and that is why they have said it like crossing, that involved crossing of river from one part to the other part.
But then only that one side was called Jamna Par. This side, one side was never called Jamna Par. So is there any reason for that?
Ma'am, I'm not sure, but I can think of one reason.
Yeah.
Probably in the earlier period when it was called Jamna Par, more population was inhabited in the western part. And that is why they would have called it Jamna Par.
So what is this urban slum problem in Delhi?
Ma'am, it is due to the unplanned development of the city. And around 11% of our Delhi's population lives in slums. Ma'am, also Delhi being a center, economic center, it attracts a large migrant population from states like UP and Bihar. And in the absence of affordable housing in the city, the people end up living in slums.
And what is this PM's Awas Yojana?
Ma'am, PM Awas Yojana has two components, the rural component and the urban component. In the urban component, it aims at providing 2 crore houses by 2022 to the poor and the those who live in the dilapidated.
Is it also applicable on urban slums?
Ma'am, those who are living in urban slums are also eligible as far as the economic criteria of the scheme is concerned. I'm not sure about the other criterias, like there is a criteria of LPG connection in the household. There's also a criteria about the vehicle that is owned by the people. Ma'am, largely most of the population of the slums would be eligible for this scheme.
But do they actually get benefited by such schemes? How practical are these in implementation?
Ma'am, a small section of the people do get benefits, but largely people are not able to get the benefits because of the lower penetration of the schemes, and also, ma'am, lesser.
What do you mean by lower penetration of the scheme?
Ma'am, the lesser awareness among people about such schemes of the government, and ma'am, the state governments also need to advertise these schemes and use the ground grassroots networks, that is ASHA workers, Anganwadi workers, so that the awareness among the people about the these good schemes can be there.
The ASHA workers, it was in news, I think, today or in tomorrow's news. Do you know what is the news about ASHA workers in Delhi, about the salaries and all? If you're reading the newspaper, if you can share the news about ASHA workers.
Ma'am, I did read about the salaries being not given to the ASHA workers for the past few months, and they have raised the issue regarding this, but I'm not aware about the details of the issue as such.
Okay, can you, last question, can you comment on the status of safety of women in Delhi? Any initiatives by government, state government with respect to this?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the state government has installed around 11 lakh CCTV cameras, in fact.
But you, as a female, as a lady, as a woman, do you feel that the city is safe for women? What is your view?
Ma'am, the safety parameter of the Delhi has improved after the Nirbhaya case. But certain precautions...
What is the change? What was something which you never used to do earlier and post Nirbhaya case you are able to do? Again, with respect to safety.
Ma'am, is this regarding to like the restrictions of the movement or...
No. How do you feel safer after this and why do you feel safer after Nirbhaya?
Ma'am, in the Nirbhaya case, firstly, ma'am, there were no air marshal, the bus marshals in the DTC buses. Bus marshals are also there, so the women are more or less hesitant in traveling in the public transport. Ma'am, also the dark spots of the city have been lightened up. That also provides a sense of security among women when they move out in the night.
11 lakh CCTV. Delhi is the most CCTV dense city in the world. What are the challenges that could arise from having extensive CCTV?
Sir, in absence of the regulations for the uses of footages by the RWAs in the city, it can create a network for surveillance in the city. Recently, the government had also said that the permission of the MLA is required in order to access the footage of from these CCTVs.
How can we balance security and privacy?
Sir, we have to walk the tight rope in this regard because both are important for the dignified life of a citizen. And sir, the penetration of technology in our lives have created some privacy concerns, but data protection bill is the need of the hour, whereby the consent of the user or the citizen is required in case his or her footage is used for any purpose.
Delhi government has decided to reopen schools.
Yes, sir.
I think by September 1st week, yes, they are planning to open. What is your opinion about this?
Sir, since the positivity rate in Delhi is far below 1%, we can consider opening up of the schools because there is a difference in the physical mode of education and the online mode of education. Also, sir, the government has pushed for the standard operating protocols to be followed in the schools, like staggered timetable is there and there is a minimum 1 hour gap in between conducting of two classes. Also, the sir, schools are open for class 9 to 12 at present, and the government is also considering the vaccination of students, given the Zydus came out with a vaccine which can be administered to 12-year above students.
Okay. Maruti was recently fined by Competition Commission.
Yes, sir.
What was the issue about?
Sir, Maruti was fined by the Competition Commission of India regarding the discount policy. It had put the maximum, the upper ceiling of the discount on the dealers, whereby the dealers could not give any above discount than the maximum discount given by the Maruti. And in one of the cases, the discount fine was even greater than the discount offered by the dealers. So, as per the Competition Commission of India, it was distorting the competitiveness in the market. So that is why it was under its radar.
The government recently mentioned that India has to play a role in the supply chain, global supply chain of EV vehicles. What can we contribute in EV vehicle global supply chain?
Sir, in EVs, the first thing that is there is the batteries. Sir, since we are dependent for lithium on the other nations, sir, we can contribute through manufacturing and assembly, whereby the make in India and assemble in India can play a greater role. And sir, also being our automotive hub for the global world, we can invest in R&D so that affordable electric vehicles are there, and thereby we can export those vehicles to other countries.
Maruti has said that it is not going to enter the EV market in the immediate future. Is that not a, is it a positive thing or a negative thing?
Sir, Maruti could have taken that decision because of its own limitations regarding its already transiting from the BS4 fuels to BS6 compliant vehicles, and in the future it probably will enter the market given the competitiveness and the other players also capturing the market. There are a number of EVs which are being launched by the other companies. So there are both aspects to it, sir.
Vehicle scrappage policy.
Yes, sir.
Uh, Can you tell me what would be the, what do you call it, outcome of vehicle scrappage policy? How will the vendors be able to make money out of this?
Sir, in the vehicle scrappage policy, the intention is to firstly reduce the vehicular emission from the old vehicles, which are contributing around 20% of the air pollution. And sir, secondly, we'll be able to utilize the steel or the other materials which are there, which can be recovered from the old vehicles after scrapping them. Sir, that can reduce the energy consumption in the furnaces, because the regular iron that we import and these irons, there's a reduction of 30% in the energy consumption. And sir, thirdly, we are also boosting the demand by removing those out of end of life vehicles from the roads. The centers can earn by recovering the materials from the vehicles, the renewable materials or the other materials like platinum or the nickel, which are used in the electronic systems or the infotainment systems of a car, and thereby they can sell it to...
Last question. Other policies by the government to deal with vehicular related pollution?
Sir, government has been pushing for FAME, the faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electric vehicles. That is also aimed to decrease the air pollution. Sir, also National Hydrogen Mission, that is also being promoted by the central government to take care of the fuel needs, and we are promoting R&D in that regard. Sir, as far as the state government's initiatives are considered, sir, Smog Tower was recently inaugurated by the CM of Delhi in the city.